Hello everyone, welcome to Libraryland. Let's start with our song. Yeah, March, 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 March. Spring is here, how do you think I know? I see a bluebird, that is how I know. Spring is here, how do you think I know? I see a flower, that is how I know. Spring is here, how do you think I know? I see the bunny, that is how I know. Spring is here, how do you think I know? I see a rainbow, that is how I know. Spring is here, how do you think I know? I see the blue sky, that is how I know. Spring is here, how do you think I know? I feel the sunshine, that is how I know. Good job, everyone. Okay, go sit down, take a deep breath, and get ready for our book. Today, I'm gonna read a book of sleep. A book about how all the animals are sleeping. And the author is Il Sang Na. And he's also the illustrator. So he made and the words and the pictures. Okay, let's look in the dark sky. When the sky grows dark and the moon glows bright, everyone goes to sleep, except for the watchful owl. Some sleep in peace and quiet on their mommy's back. Some make lots of noise when they sleep. Who's doing that in your house? Ooh, I think I know. Some sleep standing up. While some sleep on the move. That's the big whale. When he sleeps, he still can swim. He needs to swim to get his oxygen. Some sleep with one eye open, like all the pigeons. Some sleep with both eyes open, like the fish. They don't even blink. Some sleep peacefully alone, while others sleep all together, huddled close at night. Oh, the penguins. But when the sky turns blue and the sun glows bright, everyone wakes up. Look at those penguins. Ooh, sliding off the big wheel. Except for the tired owl. Zzz, he is asleep. He's tired now. So, and that is the end of the book. So, let's put that aside and get ready for our play. Yeah, there we go. They make two big owls. Owl, eyes, what do I say? Eyes, an owl has big eyes. There was a wide-eyed owl with a pointy nose and pointy ears and claws as toes. He sits in a tree and he looks at you. He flaps his wings and he says, "Hoo-hoo! Good job. Shall we do that again? Yes, let's do it again. There's a wide-eyed owl with a pointy nose and pointy ears and feet and claws as toes. He sits in a tree and he looks at you. He flaps his wings and said, "Hoo-hoo! Good job, everyone. Good job. What do you think? Can we make a little owl today? It's just a paper towel roll or a toilet paper roll. Here it is. You get your thumb on the edge and you fold it in. You have another thumb on the edge and you fold it in. So you made two big pointy ears. Then you get a marker. And what did I say? How big were the eyes of an owl? Big, wasn't it? Really big. So you just make a big eye on one side, a big eye under the other ear, you see, and give him a little black dot in it. Then he looks much smarter. There we go. Or sleepy, I don't know what this is. Oh, not a big good drawer. Then we give him a pointy nose. A pointy nose. And we can decorate his ears. For his ears. And give him a lot of feathers. And the feathers are little letters V. Oh, it's hard to draw that. So I will show you this picture again. All little V's are making the feathers. Some feathers on his ears, around his eyes. Oh, and he's smart, isn't it? So he needs a big wrinkle on his head. Okay, boys and girls, have fun doing that. But let's finish our story time with the song, yeah? Hello, springtime. Hello, springtime. Hello, springtime. I'm happy that spring is here. Hello, flowers. Hello, flowers. Hello, flowers. I'm happy that spring is here. Hello, green grass. Wiggle your fingers. Hello, green grass. Hello, green grass. I'm happy that spring is here. Hello, birds. Hello, birds. Hello, birds. I'm happy that spring is here. And I was happy that you were here. See you next time. Bye-bye.